Hello, Kulkarni sir. Welcome, sir. Welcome. And thank you for accepting our request for today. I was just going through your website. You are already producing so many things with printed electronic.
Yes.
Yeah, just visited your website today and found that you are already doing the things.
Yeah.
Wonderful, sir.
Right. From very long time we are into
this. That's wonderful, sir. When you started this printed electronics?
See, basically, if you see the foundation of our business, it is based on printed electronics only.
Okay.
We started in 1994, so almost 20 years ago. We started printing conductive inks.
Okay.
That's it was limited to the application of membrane keyboards.
Okay.
So the, now applications are more. So we have been using these inks since last 28 years.
And which method are you using, screen printing or any other method?
Exclusively screen printing.
Only screen. Namaskar, sir.
Yes, namaskar, Professor Chopra.
Welcome,
after
sir.
Long time.
Yeah. This pandemic has just diverted all the things.
Yeah.
Slowed down many things. But this Rajesh Kulkarni is already doing printed electronics at Pune.
I know them.
You know him.
I know them. He visited us. We talked together, actually. So they are doing a very good work. I know their challenges also. We are sharing the same challenges. It is initial phase. I know them. They are really doing a great work. Yeah, absolutely. I think the initial stage, when you go to the greater depth or something, I think Rajesh would agree. Initial stage, there is a lot much scope for the printers who are willing to diversify or who are willing to use their asset. Okay, because why you make a complicated product? Make a simple product which market takes it. Just print that basic conducting line, make that basic labels, printed label, electronic signature, the label with the branding or something. It's a huge market. Basically, the China, they're eating. Go with the simple one, I think.
Sir, we have with us Mr. Sanath. He's from Sri Lanka.
Yes.
Hi, how are you?
Hi, I'm fine. Thank you. Actually, we don't have any experience on printed electronics.
Professor Chopra said exactly the right thing. Nobody has the experience in printed electronics. If somebody says that, you forget it. Everybody is learning. So it's just printing. Like you are printing other things, you are printing that conductive things, basically some structures. It's just printing.
Yeah.
You have to just learn to print it accurately. That's it.
Yes. Yeah, sure.
A lot many people now, Professor Chopra are contacting us. I don't know what is the reason. You may be knowing more. We were thinking that. But a lot many people are contacting, especially for the, label with the display.
Yeah.
Visual. Whether it's a branding or information or something, it is with a display label or something basically having that.
Okay.
Even the big companies from the NCR region, they were also saying that how to basically manufacture here and how to work together. A lot many people are coming with that.
Sir said that people should start with small things.
Yes.
One of the example where we started very small, elections, 2019, I think, this elections, we printed the batches for these various parties like BJP and...
Exactly. See the volume? Absolutely. This is the way. I'm not saying that hybrid unique, the printers should take that the easy way of printing of the line, connecting the component, go for the hybrid electronics, is a huge scope.
So friends, with this series of virtual meetings on different subjects, our India Federation of Master Printers tries to educate the printers about the latest innovations and shape of your business post-COVID. So friends, I was just talking about what we are going to do today. It is the 7th edition of the series of virtual meeting being arranged by AIFMP in collaboration with the leading printing institutes and universities of India. Today, we'll be discussing how the electronics can be printed by you. Yes, you can print the electronics also. So friends, once again, welcome. Really, it is a great moment to see you during this pandemic time. Though things are now starting opening up and the restrictions are being diluted by the government. But at the same time, experts are forecasting the danger of third wave, which can be avoided only if we start following the government instructions, following the guideline given by the government. Therefore, please, please don't forget to wear mask. Always keep social distance and follow the guideline issued by the government from time to time. On behalf of Printers of India in general and All India Federation of Master Printers in particular, I wish to thank the management of Avinashi Lingam University for Women, Coimbatore, for the support they have extended for today's virtual meeting. Friends, talking about All India Federation of Master Printers, popularly known as AIFMP, it is the apex body of 250,000 printing companies of India. And it is the largest printers association in the world. Established in 1953, AIFMP draws its strength from various regional associations spread across the country. AIFMP is committed for the growth and development of printing and packaging sector. AIFMP supports, participates in, and organizes a number of regional, national, and international technical seminars for educating the printers about global trends and the coming technologies. Printing Times is the official journal of AIFMP, National Award for Excellence in Printing, popularly known as NAEP, is organized by AIFMP to motivate and recognize the talented printers. The international trade show COMEX is the prime event which is organized every alternate year to keep the printers abreast with the technological development taking place in the global printing industry. The next COMEX is planned to be held in April next, if the conditions permit. Printing is the biggest invention of mankind till date. And friends, it will not lose its importance even during the centuries to come. However, the technology, the method of printing may change. But believe me, printing will remain and printing can never die. Over the decades, we have witnessed many transformations. From early age of block printing, letterpress, to offset, then digital, and today we are celebrating printed electronic and 3D printing. The most exciting and revolutionary change mankind has witnessed in the printing industry. Technological advances in this day and age is moving at such a rapid pace that what we thought fantastic and impossible in the past are now hairs breadth away from becoming a reality. The print industry is one area that has been affected by major significant changes. Earlier, at the time of its invention, printing was considered to be an art or say craft. But over the years, it has invaded the world of technology. And with the adoption of offset, it has morphed into a combination of art, technology, science, and chemistry. In the age of computers, electronics soon became part of it, and world signaled the advent of digital printing. But the story of its expansion continues, and printing has now embraced space science, architectures, biology, and whatnot. Not only this, now electronic signals can also be printed. Printed electronics is set of printing methods used to create electrical devices on various substrates. Printing typically uses common printing equipment suitable for defining patterns on materials such as screen printing, flexography, gravure, offset lithography, and inkjet. By electronic industry standards, these are low cost processes. So this is a point to be noted. If we print the electronic, it is low cost than it is made manually. That's why it can invade the industry. Electrically functional electronic or optional optical inks are deposited on the substrate, creating active or passive devices such as film transistors, capacitors, coils, resistors. Some researchers expect printed electronic to facilitate widespread and low cost, low performance electronics for applications such as flexible displays, smart labels, decorative and animated posters, and active clothing that do not require high performance of electronics. Because of comparatively low cost of production, the printing electronic is becoming popular day by day. And friends, I'm confident that whatever the packaging market today, with printed electronics, the market will grow at least 300% tomorrow. How to adopt printed electronic, or say how to print electronic? So today we have with us experts to reveal these facts. It is our privilege that Dr. K.N. Rajarao, Director, School of Engineering, Avinashi Lingam Institute of Women, Coimbatore, not only agreed to be the chief guest for today's seminar, but he's kind enough to guide us through his keynote address. Thanks, sir, for accepting our request. Today, there are experts who are practically using printed electronic for creating different products. Think, who else can be better to guide us on printing, converting to the, or to the printers who are converting to the printed electronics? We have with us Mr. Shivanandan Muthukumar from Sudhan Graphic Coimbatore, who is producing different kind of labels and stickers with printed electronics. And Mr. Rajesh Kulkarni, Director Keytronic Pune, who is using the technology for creating printed heaters, printed lamps, printed force sensors, printed flexible circuits, and many more. I'm obliged with the presence of you both, sir, and accepting our request for guiding the printers of India. Thank you, sir, for joining. The National Center for Flexible Electronic is created by the Government of India at IIT Kanpur. That Dr. Sudhir Kumar, Chief Operating Officer of this center, is with us and has very kindly accepted to guide us about the printed electronic and functioning of National Center of Flexible Electronics. Thanks, sir, for joining. Printed electronic is an interesting subject, as it is a very interesting subject. And you all must be waiting to know how you can print heaters, lamps, and circuits, and how you can take the benefit of this latest technology. Therefore, I don't wish to stand between you and the experts, and would like to invite our dynamic personality of print world, and who is kind enough to accept our request to moderate today's event. And she is the perfect in doing it, because she is also experimenting printed electronic at her own. I would like to mention the name Dr. T.K.S. Lakshmi Priya, PhD in computer science, has developed deep love for printing industry and heads the Department of Printing Technology at Avinashi Lingam Institute of Women, Coimbatore. She has over 30 national and international publications to her credit. Dr. Lakshmi Priya strongly believes in need for strong bond between the academia, industry, and government to foster the future generation of our nation. She has been associated with almost all the activities of All India Federation of Master Painters. She is also a member of the Governing Council of the All India Federation of Master Painters. Thank you, Dr. Lakshmi Priya, and over to you for conducting today's proceeding. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Kamalji. It's a pleasure to be here at AIFMP's webinar series. So let's move on to the event of the day. First, I would like to welcome the participants of this session. Kamalji has already welcomed our chief guest and the speakers. I'm here to welcome the honorary members of the AIFMP, the faculty members of printing institutes all over India. We also have people from across the boundary, that is from Sri Lanka and other countries as well. I welcome you all. It's a pleasure to welcome the students and the alumni of various institutions as well. The day will not begin without an introduction to Kamalji himself. So let me have the honor of introducing Professor Kamal Mohan Chopra, the President of All India Federation of Master Printers for the second time. He is the proprietor of Oil Printers in Ludhiana. He is a diploma in the Printing Technology, Printing Management from NRIPT Allahabad in 1968, and he has become the honorary professor of Beijing Institute of Graphic Communication from 2016 onwards. It's a privilege to the print industry that one of our Indian printers is an honorary professor in a foreign country. Yet another feather to his crown is the book Life in Print. Kamalji, Life in Print has been published as a book last year during the pandemic period. Kamalji always says, whatever I am is because I am a printer. The proud to be printer jargon originated from Kamalji himself. About the various accolades, he is the chairman of the World Print and Communication Forum since 2020, another prestigious position on a global level. He's a chairman of PAMEX and nominee to the Court of Decrest University. There are several awards, and I am very thankful that we have a guide and mentor in him. Thank you very much, Kamalji. I would like to give a short introduction to our institute. The Avinashling Institute for Home Science and Higher Education for Women in Coimbatore was started by our founder, Thiru T.S. Avinashalingam. He is a Padma Bhushan, the first education minister of Madras Presidency. He introduced Thirukural in schools during his ministership. We all know that our former president, APJ Abdul Kalam, always recites Thirukural. Probably it was inspired by his school textbook, and indirectly our founder has played a role in that. Our founder was a freedom fighter, and in 1930s, he started the Ramakrishna Mission Vidyalaya in Coimbatore exclusively for boys. It is today a deemed university and handed over to the Ramakrishna Mission Vidyalaya itself, Ramakrishna Mission. On the same lines, he started another institute for women, and that is what we are in. We now, the School of Engineering is located in the second campus of the Avinashalingam Institute, which is a deemed university today and has received several accolades, including the NAC, and our engineering has been awarded, the printing Department of Printing Technology has been awarded the NBA. Why have we chosen printer electronics? Since the Drupa 2016, our department has been exploring the print 4.0 technologies, and printed electronics is one of them. So our students since 2018 have been doing projects on printed electronics, and these are some of them. You can see a nappy burn incinerator here, which is an interactive display. On pressing a button, you can see an LED glowing on the picture of the instrument, and thereby the electronics behind it, the printed electronics works. What you see on the right side is a small greeting card, where the LED glows. So these have all been done in the lab, which means that printed electronics can be done in the lab on a very small scale as well. The latest of our students' projects is a smart package. And during the lockdown period, they have been able to do this, the current final year batch. And some of these components, they were not able to get the micro small level components, as a result of which it has not a complete flexible smart electronics. So with that introduction, let us look at the series of talks that we are going to see today. Our director, Professor Raja Rao, would be giving us an overview of printed electronics. The first speaker of the day, Mr. Sivanandam, will give us scope for printed electronics from an MSME point of view. Mr. Sivanandam is a proprietor of an MSME unit who is doing printed electronics. Followed by a talk by Mr. Rajesh Kulkarni of Pune, who will be talking to us about a little more advanced printed electronics. And then comes Dr. Sudhir, who will talk to us about facilities and services that's available at IIT Kanpur. So we have a three different range of speakers today at different levels. Let us start the session with our chief guest. Let me have the honor of introducing our director, School of Engineering, Professor K.N. Rajarao. Sir is a BE, ME, Electronics and Communication Engineering graduate. He has been the principal and advisor of RV College of Engineering, Bengaluru, before he became the director of our School of Engineering in 2019. There are several awards and achievements to his credit, including the Best Faculty Award by Cognizant, Distinguished Service Award, DRDO's Director's Appreciation, Best Mentor Award, and Citation. He has authored two books on satellite communication, and may I request, sir, to give us the inaugural talk. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Lakshmi Priya. Shall I present my slides? Thanks to AIFMP, Mr. Kamal, and Dr. Lakshmi Priya, Madam, for inviting me for this very nice webinar. And I think this is what is needed at this time. Mr. Kamal, resource persons, members of AIFMP, faculty members, other students, and I am not sure who all are there in the audience. So thank you for being with us today. I think this printed electronics already Dr. Kamal has put a lot of inputs about what it is. And I think this is something which has to be taken up very seriously in these days. The reason for this is that as Jeff Gibson, CEO of Xerox, says, revenues at the print services company have been steadily declining for years, dropping by about 6% in 2016. And further, he says, we are in the very early stages, but that's where we are placing bets right now. And Xerox is already experimenting with printed electronics, for example, making smart packages that can help tracking a package or offer information about a product that could be a food produced, which could be spoiled or not. And what Xerox is doing today is something which is very astonishing if you look at, though we call Xerox, but actually Xerox is a company and not a photocopying thing. So what Xerox today is doing is, I'll just play a video. It's basically talking of what, you know, Xerox is doing on packaging. let us go to other things. And printed electronics is not a new thing. It has been there since 1940, and Hansen proposed printed circuits board on copper foil much, much earlier. In fact, in 1903 itself, Hansen had to, done something on that. But actually, the PCBs started coming from 1940 onwards. Today's printed electronics is manufactured mostly utilizing one of the old manufacturing methods combined with novel materials. And it is estimated that the projected growth is going to be 7.8 billion, which was in 2020, to about 20.7 billion by 2025. So the printed electronics is going to be the boom, and printed electronic circuits like display sensors, RFIDs, thin film transistors, printed tags, displays, printed batteries, photovoltaic cell, and so many other consumer items would be coming soon. Speciality of printed electronics are lightweight, bendable, foldable, rollable, conformal, wearable, and offer the possibility of creating devices, sensors on variety of substrates, unlike traditional microelectronics. The problem with the traditional microelectronics, we are having a set of substrates which can only be used. If you look at what is the development that is happening in the printed electronics, the printed electronics requires research, design and development, raw material suppliers, equipment suppliers, component manufacturers, original equipment manufacturers, suppliers and distributors, and end users. Why this particular webinar is very important for us today is because if you look at the three things, one is research and design and development, raw material development and supplies, and component manufacturing. These three things are very, very important to start with. And all these three things can be taken by academia. And therefore, this particular webinar where academia is there, also the industry people are there, this particular webinar will be very useful. And I hope that, a lot of inputs will be coming from Flex Lab of IIT Kanpur, who are doing a lot of work. I have been in touch with them for some time, some years back, and they have been doing a lot of work on this. Growth of printed electronics. In 2007, companies such as PolyIC and Covio proposed completely printed RFID tags, which operated at 13.59 megahertz. In 2013, thin film printed was demonstrated. In 2014, the first integrated printed electronic temperature tracking sensor system powered solely by batteries coupled with near-field communication came into being. In 2016, package for monitoring perishable goods based on organic conducting and semiconducting as well as portable inorganic materials came into being. In 2020, micro supercapacitor arrays that can provide energy storage along with flexibility and stretchability was also, came in Pennsylvania State University. And I think Flex Lab IIT Kanpur is also working on that. The technologies that have been in the back of this printed electronics is printing techniques applied for printing electronics are nothing new here. They are the same things which have been used in the printed industries, gravure printing, flexographic, offset, screen, and inkjet printing. So all these are same. Each of these processes have its benefits and limitations and depends upon the application where we want to use them. Flexible, very thin with combination of specialty materials known as large area flexible electronic processes came up for consumer electronics, which are energy efficient, thin, flexible. Flexographic printing technology results in thinnest printed layer of 80 micrometers, and these can produce from 3 to 30 meters square per second. These are useful for healthcare devices. Screen and inkjet printing give higher layer thickness of up to 100 micrometers and up to 20 micrometers respectively. Screen printing has lower throughputs of 2 to 3 meters square per second, while inkjet printing has 0.01 to 0.1 meter square per second, used in RFID tags, textiles, etc. Three important components of the printed electronics are substrate, ink, and overcoats. So these three things are very important. I will just look at these three things. So the first is the substrate. Choice of substrates depends on the application, cost, and performance. Common used substrates are polyesters, polyamides, fabrics, and papers, stretchable materials, which are combination of various organic and inorganic materials. If you look at where we can use this, then we see that the flexibility of polyester is very good. Polyamide is also good. Fabric and paper is also good. Stretchable material is also good. But when you come to component integration, how many components we can put together on the printing circuit, then polyester and polyamides have average integration, and similarly, fabric, paper, and stretchable material have very low component integration. Process characteristics of polyester are average, but polyamides are very good, and fabric, paper, and stretchable materials are average. The cost of production of these is very low in the case of polyester as well as fabric and paper, but as far as polyamide and stretchable materials is concerned, the cost is not very low. The performance is also good in polyester and polyamide. The problem is that fabric and paper as well as stretchable material are not very good as far as the performance is concerned, and maybe they are there for only a few months or so. The inks that are used are the conductive inks, which are silver or silver chloride or graphene. Carbon inks and pastes are available for resistors. Dielectric inks are available for UV treated epoxy, boron nitrides, and these are used for protection and energy storage devices. And for overcoat inks, epoxy based final protection is done. Overcoats are of course very important, because once we have the printed circuit, we need to protect them from the environment. Special inks are also available today, which are piezoelectric polymers or thermochromic or electrochromic, and these are very useful as far as sensing is concerned. So these, most of them are used for sensors. New inks are also nowadays very common. Organic inks based on combination of polymers is also available today. The printing processes in power electronics is either clean room based or it would be a non-clean room based. If you see clean room based, I require at least a class one type of clean room where spin coating, inkjet, photolitho, and vacuum could be used. These are used for applications in TVs and e-readers. Whereas the most commonly what we are looking at is the non-clean room based, which may have a greater than class 100 room, where PPMs may be quite high. Almost about 100,000 PPMs is sufficient for non-clean room based, and I think that that takes this printing electronics much above the clean room based. So here we can use gravure, flexo, or offset litho, or 3D printing. The applications could be rotary and flatbed screens, RF tags, smart sensors, packaging, and so on and so forth. Lot of, you know, applications could be there in the non-clean room based also. But only thing is, in the non-clean room based, I cannot have very big circuits or active circuits. What are the challenges? The challenges are manufacturing challenges, where the processing speed and time is a very important thing which cannot be very high. Curing and drying temperature time and tolerance is also a very big issue in printed electronics. Yield and uniformity monitoring is also a problem, because we can't have very good uniformity when we do the printed electronics. Health, safety, and environmental impact is also one of the things, because the inks that we use are not very safe. Then if you come to substrate challenges, smoothness is something, because if I want to print on textile, smoothness is very poor, or on paper, the smoothness is very poor. So substrate challenges are very, again, a great thing which we have to look into how to overcome that. Porosity, wettability, incompatibility properties, these are some of the challenges which are still existing in printing technology. And therefore, I think we have to look at new substrates which could be good enough. For example, textiles. If I want to have smart textiles, then we need to look at substrates which could help us. Then device challenges, durability, stability, and reliability are the three important things which are very, very important. Because as it looks, today's printed electronics, all these three are very low, and therefore whether we can have long-term durability, stability, and reliability circuits is a big question mark. Building awareness and confidence is another challenge. Because as of now, we have a lot of confidence on the technology, silicon technology we are using. But do we have that same confidence that these circuits will work properly for years? No, we don't have that. And therefore, this building confidence is very much required, and that can only come through research and development. The three building blocks which are important for ecosystems is the academic ecosystem, the research ecosystem, and the industrial ecosystem. And only when all these three work together, there will be a possibility that we will have very good printed electronics ecosystem. So under the academic ecosystem, I do not think there is any curriculum development happening. This is one of the very important things which the academia has to look at, how to develop various curriculums for various processes in the printed electronics. Enhancing laboratory facilities. Even laboratory facilities are very poor. Well, in most of the institutes where you are having printed technology. So therefore, those institutions where you have printed technologies, it is necessary that we enhance the laboratory facilities for printed electronics, and also reduce the skill gap, because faculty itself are not skilled to teach these courses. And therefore, to make it a success, it is very essential that the institutions like IIT Kanpur is doing, we need to have more such interactions, and maybe the IIT Kanpur can take the lead in producing faculty who will have good skills. I know they are doing a lot of work, because when I was in RB College, we were having a very close contact with IIT Kanpur, and we had sent our faculty there for training. Then why not Printing Technology Institute send their faculty to IIT Kanpur to get, training there? So this skill gap will be automatically reduced. Research ecosystem is also important, because research in printing, printed electronics is very much required for all the three, substrate, as well as the inks, as well as the processes. And therefore, this research in printing electronics has to go on. Development of prototypes is something which has to happen, because only developing substrates or inks cannot help. We have to build various prototypes, whether it is for assistive technology, whether it is for packaging, whether it is for RF tags, and so on and so forth. So we need to have that research ecosystem within all the institutions, and that is possible if the industry supports. So industry support for research is very important, and therefore engaging academia in prototyping is something which the industries need to do, and I hope that AIFMP will take a lead role in this and see how they can help the institutions develop this. Provide sabbaticals and internship opportunities for the students so that they will be able to see what is happening. As you already you said that, you know, a printer in Coimbatore is doing it, but are our faculty or are our students aware of this? So if they can go to this industry and, you know, spend some time, they will know how the printed electronics happens and they can learn about it. In conclusion, I just want to say that printed electronics has a bright future, as consumer items like fashionable clothing, greeting cards, sensor patches, and more would be in great demand in days to come. All wearable devices need not be printed and smart. For example, a watch, what we are seeing today, is not a printed circuit, but it is useful. So we cannot say that all, you know, consumable items will be printed. But whatever is important, whatever we feel that, you know, are important for for thin film as well as for thick film, that have to go into the printed electronics. 3D printed electronics is emerging as a viable process for printed electronics, as evidenced by Voxel, a startup by a professor, and he has developed a lot of sensors and circuits through 3D printing. So 3D printing is something I think which is going to stay for long, particularly for printed electronics. It is an emerging area for printing courses and requires attention from institutions running printing technology. And it is necessary that academia and industries work hand in hand to bring this technology to Indian market at the earliest. And therefore, I do hope that AIFMP as well as the institutions will join hands together and see that printed electronics is brought to the students, brought to the industry, and brought to the consumers. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Yeah, sir, thank you very much. It was an excellent speech, a complete speech. You started off with the roadmap saying that printed electronics started in the early 19th century, 1900s. That's really nice to hear, and I think we should take off very fast. And then followed by what kind of technology, substrates and inks that are required, that was very much in the printing jargon only. And it's also interesting to know that we need to have clean rooms, or even without clean rooms, printers can get into printed electronics jobs. And then you have also listed the tasks and given assignments to researchers, AIFMP, faculty, students, and also printers to take up printed electronics and form a very nice ecosystem. There is a lot of scope for us. Thank you very much, sir. It was a pleasure to have you here with us.
Sir, thank you very much for your guidance.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thanks for your time. Regarding, and I'm also thankful to you for being fabricator of the future printing, because you are training the future printers. All that. That's why we are always trying to associate with the teaching institutes. It is not we are doing any favor to you, sir. We are doing favor to ourselves, because you are creating our future. You are writing the future of Indian painting industry. We are, as you said, here, sir, we are always there for any type of assistance. Regarding that training part, I assure that we have already created a cell at the office of All India Federation of Master Painters. Any student wish to get training anywhere in India, they can approach and we will try that the student can be adjusted for training purpose. So that we already started, sir. Any other service for the cause of, it is because it is not your service, not for the students or for the teachers, it is for ourselves. You are creating our future and our future are in the hand of the future painters, these young students who are studying printing today. So sir, thank you very much. And any type of assistance from All India Federation, I assure you, we are there, sir. Thank you very much for your time, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
May I now give an introduction to the next speaker, the first speaker of the day, Mr. Sivanandam, proprietor, Sudan Graphics, Coimbatore. He is a printer who basically does epoxy dome resin stickers, dome labels, machine keypad labels, etc. Sudan Graphics was established in 2009 in Coimbatore in Tamil Nadu, and Mr. Sivanandam has started printing printed electronics as a commercial product. He has helped our department in many ways, and we entered into printed electronics in a very small scale in the lab because of him. Over to you, sir. Please tell and guide the printers how MSMEs can quickly enter into printed electronics.
Good evening, all. I'm Sivanandam from Sudan Graphics, Coimbatore. Thank you for giving the wonderful opportunity. Sorry for the inconvenience. I have a vendor meeting, so I can't attend the webinar now. So forward to my daughter now, so handle it. Thank you once again. I'm sorry for the inconvenience.
No issue, sir. We understand. Essential.
Okay. Thank you for.
So since Mr. Sivanandam is doing essential printing and he has to leave to the vendor, his daughter who has just completed BE will take over his. We are very happy to have the next generation join in and handhold her father. This is exactly what we are looking from the younger generation. Whether the daughter or son is in printing or not in printing, we would like you to support the parent. Aishwarya.
Good evening all. I am Aishwarya, daughter of Sivanandan. Today's topic is printer electronics and its development. It's about our company. Our company has started in the year 2019 in Coimbatore. We are one of the leading business in the label manufacturing, such as label manufacturing like dome stickers, keypad labels, then warning stickers, etc. We have wide range of products and services towards our customers. These are a few products: keypad stickers, and these are other few products like dome label, inspection label, warning labels, vinyl security labels, and eco solvent labels and PC labels, and so on. Though we have been a leading one, we have faced many challenges. At initial stage, we have faced lots of challenges like insufficient money, lack of skilled labor, difficult to find customer, and also few materials will not be available in our location. So we need to buy them from other states. In that situation, there will be a time delay. So this will be a major problem faced by us. Few tips for the MSME members. To succeed. MSME members have many opportunity to succeed in their business. They can easily get government subsidies and bank loans for developing their business. MSME member can get big company orders. To succeed in our business, the main thing is customer satisfaction and product quality. It is the main thing to succeed in our business. Based on the resource availability, orders should be taken. These are the few tips from our side to succeed in their business, and these are the things we have came through. Thank you.
Thank you for filling the gap. we understand that MSMEs do have a lot of challenges in doing this kind of latest technology businesses, and you have succeeded. Sudan Graphics has succeeded, and the conclusion with whatever resources you have, you need to do, you should continue is a very nice tip that you have given to the printers here. I think they will all be inspired. Kamalji?
Can it be possible to show some samples here on the camera?
One second, sir. I will try to show.
Actually, why we are invited him? He's a small size printer, or if he can do it, you all can do it. So just see if the things he is producing. Till the samples are being shown to you, I may tell that it is a vision only. Technology, as sir said, Dr. already said that technology was there even 40 years back. There was this technology was available. We didn't try to use it. That is our problem. So see the samples they have produced. Madam, can you tell what are these samples?
They are switch keypad stickers. That is for machines when you have that press button kind of a control panel or keypad kind of a panel. This is what is printed above them. Instead of putting a plain sticker, paper or sticker and the button being on the machine, there is an electric circuit behind the sticker. So this sticker itself is in multiple layers. You can see the thickness in this side.
Yeah,
there are multiple layers. The top layer is just the printed normal printing. The second layer will be the conductive ink printing. And the third layer will be a covering sheet. Three layers are there. Sometimes there are leads taken out. What you can see are the cables that are leads that are taken out to be connected to the circuit board. So that's the lead you can see in many of these being taken out from the screen printed circuit. Thank you, Aishwarya. Thank you very much. We'll move on to the second speaker of the day, Mr. Rajesh Kulkarni, Managing Director, Keytronics, Pune. He's a Bachelor of Electronics by education, and he started the Keytronics in 1994. Since then, they have a sound experience in manufacturing membrane keyboards. So he has a very good reputation in the medical instrument industry, the fuel dispensing machines, and 50% of the revenue comes from these industries for Keytronics. Keytronics has also won gold, silver, and honorary awards for their membrane key category. May I request Mr. Rajesh Kulkarni to share his views? Over to you, sir.
Very good for all of you. Myself, Rajesh Kulkarni, from a company called Keytronics India Private Limited, which is based in Pune. And as Madam told that we are already into this business for last 28 years. So I will just brief you in short what we do at Keytronics, and I will come to my topic of today's topic, that is printed electronics and in-mold electronics. So Keytronics is a company which manufactures advanced input devices. So when we say advanced input devices, it is a man-machine interface, what normally a normal person uses in a house or somebody uses in a device or a petrol pump operator uses. So whenever you interact with a machine, when you interact with a computer, we have to feed some data. So there we come into the picture. So we produce membrane keyboards, which are advanced input devices called, because we provide electronics also with that. So it is not only the membrane keyboards, we provide a complete electronic solution. That is, we provide a software, we provide a hardware, we provide the enclosure. So it is a complete device what we supply to our customers. The majority of our customers are into medical electronics, like companies like GE Healthcare, Philips, Siemens, then generator manufacturers like Cummins, Indian Railways. Even we have been supplying to light combat aircraft Tejas, and also this new train T18 Vande Bharat Express. So most of this equipments which are there in the railways or in the medical equipments, they have to be interfaced by a human being. So there we produce the membrane keyboards, that is advanced input devices. So this is one of the division what we have. The second most important division what we have is touch electrical switches. So using the capacitive technology, we have started producing touch switches for last almost 11 years. We have been highly successful in producing a complete product, which we called it as a touchmatic. So touchmatic is a touch electrical switch, which is a replacement. what you have in anchor, Legrand, or whatever switches we have in home or office. So we produce these switches on glass, on wood, on fabric, on stone, on any dielectric material we produce the switches. And we are proud to say that we have at least delivered to 25 different hotels in UAE and almost 50 to 60 hotels in India. One of them is Taj Bhopal, which is going on today. So this is the second division what we have. The third division what we produce is, of course, the printed. So functional printed electronics, we have started this division almost 12 to 15 years back. Although we have been printing conductive inks since from day one, because we are into membrane keyboard manufacturing. So we use the conductive inks, silver conductive inks, graphite inks or carbon inks since last 28 years. But exclusively making products into printed electronics, we have started this almost 12 years back. So this is just a basic about Keytronics, and I will go ahead to let you know like what exactly is in-mold electronics and what we do in in-mold electronics and what one has to have if he has to think of an in-mold electronics or even a printed electronics. So in-mold electronics is a little advanced branch of printed electronics where you have already the functional printing done and you have to fix the components onto it and you have to form the circuit. And it has to be very reliable. It has to be very rugged. So this is a little advanced version of printed electronics, what we have been doing. So let me share my screen to you first. So basically this is in-mold electronics I am going to talk about. So first let us see what is in-mold electronics. As I said, in-mold electronics is a combination of a traditional molded decorative parts. You take a toy or you take a dashboard electronics, whatever there is in an automotive. So decorative technology, what you already have, and a combination of printed electronics into it. So this is what is basically electronics. So you have to print the functional links, you have to place the components onto it, you have to form the circuitry, and you have to mold it in the proper injection molding machine. So this is what is in-mold electronics, and this is what we have been recently doing with. So the results of this is an aesthetically pleasing, highly functional, lightweight, and low-cost alternative to the traditional human-machine interface, normally which you see with the mechanical switches and lot of wiring. So IME, in-mold electronics, is gaining a popularity in the automotive, medical devices, and white good devices, such as air conditioners, air purifiers, or so many other things because of hard surfaces. It can be produced on glass, it can be produced on polyester film, it can be produced on a polycarbonate films or variety of materials you can produce this. Typically an IME application starts with a basic screen printing of multiple layers of electronic circuit, like first is the conductive silver ink, then comes the dielectric ink, then comes the jumpers, then comes the graphite ink to see that it doesn't get corroded over the period of time. So this is basically the in-mold electronics, and you have to use variety of equipments to go ahead with this. So let us talk about what kind of different inks are required in mold electronics. There may be several different inks, as Dr. Rao said. It can be a piezoelectric ink, it can be a zinc magnesium oxide ink for printing batteries, but I will talk in basic what a normal screen printer should think about of having a printed electronic setup. So basically it is a screen printing process which normally many of the printers would have been doing, and it requires a special ink. Special ink, I mean to say that it requires an ink which is stretchable. So when you print the ink and when you form it at a higher temperature, you should ensure that the ink is also stretched so the conductive tracks remains intact and you don't have any kind of cracking in the ink, so the product becomes more reliable. The second important ink which required is the conductive glue. So this conductive glue is a glue. It is actually a glue. It is a bonding glue which has a conductive properties also. So when you bond the LEDs or bond the connectors, resistors or transistors on a flexible film, you need this conductive glue. So once this conductive glue is placed, you place the component on the top of it and you pass it through an oven at maybe around 120, 150 degrees centigrade. and it gets cured. So before placing these components, you also have to do a mechanical bonding. So the bonding like Loctite, you have to fix the basic Loctite drops. So these components are mechanically bonded first, and then later on they are bonded with the conductive glue to make the connections. So once this is done, you also have to give an UV encapsulant. So this protects the entire circuitry. So when if you are folding it, if you are creasing it, or if you are handling the electronic product, still it will continue to last long and there will not be any issue. So to have a robustness in the in-mold electronics, you have to give an UV encapsulation also. So let us talk about the equipments required. Basically, a good screen printing setup, as the sir also said, that it can be a clean room, it cannot be a clean room. Even in non-clean room premises also, you can produce a printed electronic circuits. It is not that great. But you should have a basic knowledge of screen printing. You should have the basic equipments of the screen printing. And you should have an experience in printing. So that is the basic thing. The screen printing setup also should have a good quality oven, or a good quality conveyorized oven, which is an infrared oven, or even a convection oven will also do, as most of these inks are cured at the temperature of 120 degrees centigrade or more. The third important equipment which is required is a ultraviolet curing machine, and it should have the capacity like 300 nanometers per second or whatever it is mentioned as per the guidelines of the ink manufacturer. It should have the capacity to cure those inks in one pass or maximum at two pass, because when you pass it for more number of times, the electronics components may get damaged. The fourth and the very important equipment or a tool one should have is a Megger tester. It is a tester which will test the dielectric strength around 1000 volt DC. So when you are printing jumpers, you are printing a track upon a track to reduce the circuitry, to reduce the layers. You need a dielectric, and for checking the performance of this dielectric, you need a Megger tester. Also, you need a UV intensity measuring tool, so you are sure that whatever UV intensity is mentioned by the ink manufacturer, you are following that same procedure to get the desired results. So this is all about what are the basic equipment one should have to start with a printed electronic products. Okay. So what is the basic procedure? Again, coming back to the basic procedure, when you have a printed substrate, it is a decorative printed substrate, which normally one prints on a polycarbonate or prints on a polyester substrate. So it is the first layer, it is the first surface where you have all the decorative inks printed, but you should assure that these decorative inks are stretchable form. So they have to be formed, they have to be formed at a higher temperature. So you need a stretchable ink to be used to print the decorative layers. The second layer is, of course, a conductive ink layer, which is just placed behind the printed decorative layer, and the components to be fixed on it. The third step is the thermoforming. So all these layers are printed, you have to do a thermoforming. So thermoforming gives a shape, gives a structure to the part, and it looks attractive. It looks as per the designer's wish. So this is what the basic procedure is to make a part which is ready for in-mold electronics. And once this part is ready, while doing an injection molding, one has to place that part in between the mold. So when the plastic is getting molded, this part also becomes a part of it. It becomes homogeneous, and you get a very reliable, rugged part, which is of course called as in-mold electronics. So what is the expertise required? Again, coming to the very basic question, you need a very good quality screen setup, or you need a very good knowledge of screen printing, because you cannot have knowledge of screen printing. You need a very good knowledge of screen printing. And also you need a basic knowledge of electronics, because printing only the circuit layer is not going to help. So that is what we have been doing, all of us have been doing for years. So printing only conductive inks, printing only tracks, this is very long journey. So we have to think of little ahead. So when you make a functional part, when you make a printed electronic part, you should have a basic knowledge of electronics, or you should have a person who knows electronics out of that. Because people, the customer is going to expect a functional part. It is not that the customer is going to expect only a printed part. He need a functional part with that. So a functional part, I means that you print up electronics, you in-mold electronics, you have to attach a hardware, you have to attach the components, and also you have to have a program, or you have to have a software embedded into it. So it becomes a complete functional part. I will show you some of the examples what we have done, so you'll better understand that. So this is the expertise one require. It should have a good knowledge of screen printing, and of course a good setup of screen printing. And the person should have patience to read the various data sheets of the inks and various processes the supplier has mentioned, because this is very important. When you play with these things, it is very important to ensure that the right temperature is maintained, the right kind of time frame is given to cure the ink, the solvent gets evaporated very well, the UV curing is done very well, you don't have any leakages in the current. So the person should have a patience. He cannot do it in a hurry like printing a normal thing. He has to have a patience. Of course, initially he should have a understand what exactly is the printed electronics. So this is the basic expertise required by a person. Then what are the applications of IME? Electronics, as sir also said, that it is flexible, it is bendable, it has a light weight, it is robust. It gives a designer a freedom to give a different kinds of shapes. So you can imagine any shape which is possible by a thermoforming, or which is possible by 3D printing, and you can put the electronics, flexible electronics molded into it. So this is what the very, very attractive application of in-mold electronics. These applications you can find in variety of industries, like aerospace industries, like in appliance industries, like white good industries, in automobile industries, on the dashboard where you are controlling certain devices like a music system, or you are controlling some windows, you are switching on and off the windows, or any kind of device which at this moment is made with a conventional mechanical switch, you can easily replace it with a printed electronics by using a capacitive technology. And of course, that can be on any substrate, as I said earlier. It can be on a glass, it can be in a wood, it can be on a stone or anything. This is, when you see in the presentation, this is one of the very interesting product what we have done for one of our customers. So on the right-hand side, you see a carbonate film, which has been printed with a stretchable ink and a decorative symbol being placed on it. And on the left-hand side, you can see the backside of this same product. It is a functional tracks. The conductive silver ink has been used, and we have fixed variety of components. You can see we have soldered over there integrated circuit, diodes, a speaker, a small buzzer also we have connected to it. So this is a complete functional product, what we call as an IME, in-mold electronic product. So this is one of the application of in-mold electronics. Then what are the features of in-mold electronics? As I said, it is 70 to 75% lighter than the existing buttons and the wiring which has been required for an input device. So you can wave away all the wirings, you can wave away all the conventional buttons, and you can have a very sleek, thin film printed circuit, which can be also illuminated with LEDs, or it can be illuminated with electronic EL lamps. The technology also saves 30% of the cost, existing cost, in some of the applications, not in all applications. It is mainly due to the less moving parts. It is again due to the less labor required for that, and of course the less inventory you need to make this kind of products. And it gives a very good design flexibility, a design freedom for a designer to achieve his form or factor or what he has thought in his mind. A reduction of thickness, reduction of weight, it is very much required in aircraft industries, in aviation industries, because the PCBs, the glass epoxy PCBs, are having more weight, and this weight can be reduced by printing on a flexible substrate like polyester. It is more durable, as it has the embedded electronics, it is protected, and it is sealed, as I said, with UV encapsulant, and everything. So it is, most of the cases, it can be waterproof also. In conclusion, about IME, as I said, it is a very versatile technology. It is very well suited for having smart surface solutions. When you say smart surface solutions, it can be printed we have Mimaki, we have Roland digital printers also. So it is not necessary that you should print only on by screen printing. You can print it by digitally also, because the advantage of digital printing is you can have very quick turnaround. You don't need to make screens, you don't have to make the ink, you don't have to make the shades, and you can do a very small batches also, and you can turn around any requirement very quickly. So this is a very versatile technology. It works with a very new kind of inks, advanced graphene ink. One of the graphene ink, what we are doing a research for last almost 3 years with one of our customer, esteemed customer, he wanted to have a portable heater. Suppose he is expecting a heater which can be used in a battery which is already there in a laptop. So a laptop battery, what we have designed and developed a product for him using a graphene ink, it works on a very low voltage. So even a 5-volt supply, if you give a 5-volt supply, you can have a water boiling at 80 degrees centigrade. So we have made some tea coasters for him. So these tea coasters, they have distributed in their company, which can keep your coffee or your tea hot for a long time, and the power source can be a laptop. So even if you are out, if you are not with the electrical source or supply, you are portable, still you can have, you can make Maggie or you can make some other products using this portable heaters. But of course, this has been possible because of the very innovative ink which has just founded 10 or 15 years back, which is called as graphene, because it works on a very low voltage. And a lot of technical research is happening throughout the world. Unfortunately, for last 1.5 years, we could not visit any exhibitions. Normally, we go to Japan, we go to Germany, we go to Berlin for the IDTechs, and we see a lot of products, we see a lot of new technologies, new equipments coming into the market which are supporting the advancement of printed electronics in electronics. But still we can see that a lot of companies are coming with the new inks, with the new dielectrics, and which definitely is going to change the world, and which is going to bring the cost down, and more products you can see in near future. So this is what about the conclusion. Talking about Keytronics and talking about products, what we did, as I said, we have a product called printed heaters, which we have recently developed for one of our customer who requires a very small printed heater. It is just a 15 mm by 10 mm heater, which is required to detect the necrotics or detect any kind of devices, explosive devices on an aircraft, an airport. So it is a swab which we have developed. So it reaches a temperature of 80 degrees centigrade in just 10 seconds. So this is one of our successful product which we have supplied to one of our esteemed customer. Then we have electroluminescent displays. So the normal 7-segment displays, we have replaced it with electroluminescent display for one of our customers. Of course, I will be showing you some of the videos once I finish this presentation. One of our highly successful printed electronic product was a force sensing resistor, which we did for a German company. Of course, it was in collaboration with IIT Powai students, IIT Powai startup companies. And we are proud to say that almost 7 years back, this product was done, developed. And we did a business of around 60 lakh rupees with this customer, who is a German customer. And you will be very happy. Many of you already might have seen. It's a product called ACPAD, which is based on the force sensing resistor. Then we have a product called printed batteries, which is for the portable flaps or batches, what you can have on your shirt or any kind of visiting cards, which can be illuminated. So this printed batteries also we have printed at Keytronics. We have capacitive pressure sensors. So one of our customer wanted, he was an egg manufacturer, the eggs for the chicken. So he wanted to know whether the egg has got rotten. So once the egg gets rotten, the weight of the egg changes. So this capacitive pressure sensor was developed to check how the weight had changed. So you can identify in which bracket or at which location the egg has got rotten. So this was one of the project what we did for one of the company. but of course it has not come into the market. Then we have designed and developed a humidity sensor for one of our esteemed customers. So these are some of the products what we did. I will be happy to show you some of the videos.
Nice, okay.
So did you see this? This is a flexible printed display. What you normally have a 7-segment display in all of the equipments what you see. So this is printed on a 125 micron polyester film. So this is an electroluminescent lamp, which we have printed in the format of a display. So we have powered it with our electronics. So you can see that it is a variable display. Like you can see 1, 2, 3, 4 up to the 9. Okay. So this is a very good example of a flexible printed display. Of course, this we did almost 7-8 years back. So as you can see, this is a glass of around 2 mm thickness, and we have printed an electroluminescent lamp using the printed electronics technology. So this is one of the example. Then so this is a package. As you can see, the logo has been illuminated.
Yeah.
Or even you can use an very small minute LEDs, and you can glow the logo, or you can glow any part of this package. And also there is a sensor. If you see, there is a finger, the person is pressing the finger and it is getting operated. So this is a very good example of a packaging where you can use an printed electronics. Dr. Sudhir was saying, about very, very small things you can do. This is what we did in 2019.
Oh, yeah, this one. Yes, sir.
So this was a batch. Very small thing, but we sold out about 500 pieces. This is an example of a printed battery. So you can see this is a printed battery, and you can see the LED glowing.
Oh, great, great.
So we have developed this printed battery using magnesium oxide.
Wonderful, sir.
Yeah. And so this is a product called InfoDot.
Okay.
Another one of the good example of not exactly printed electronics, but in printing what you can do. This is a thermochromic ink, what we have used. And we have created such red small dots.
Yeah.
Okay. And the ink was developed in such a way that after, basically it is to detect whether a person has a fever or not. So instead of using a thermometer, this is a very good solution what we have developed almost a year back during COVID times. So what happens when you use a thermometer, when you screen the person, when he's coming inside, you check his temperature. But when he is in the office, when he's on the aircraft, when he's on the train for next 20 hours or next 12 hours, you don't know what kind of temperature his body has. So this is a device, which is a dot, which is a very simple dot, which is printed using a thermochromic ink. And you have to wear it, as I shown, you have to wear it on a neck, or you have to wear it on a forehead or on a palm, wherever you want. And this will continuously detect the temperature of the body. So as soon as the temperature of body started rising above 36 degrees centigrade, the color of this ink will start changing.
Oh.
So once it reaches 38 degrees centigrade, it will totally become white. So the person will be easily identifiable that he has developed some fever. So suppose imagine some small children going into school and you have to monitor the temperature. So it is a very tedious job. So if you place one small dot on the forehead or on the neck, the teacher can easily identify that this child has developed a fever. So this was a very innovative product. So these are some of the examples. Hope you like those examples, and some of them may find inspiring for my colleagues who are already joining this seminar. So this is all from me. Professor Chopra and Dr. Lakshmi Madam. So I hope I was in a good position to explain what we are exactly doing.
Very nice, sir. Very exciting and inspiring. many of these things which we saw, which we have seen, and in the advertisement and in probably in the shops, we never knew it was printing. We thought it was totally electronics, especially when we saw the ad of the heater that you mentioned. I really thought it was something distant and not printing at all. To know that you are behind it is really a news to us. Best wishes and congratulations, and all the best for your future as well, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Let's move on to our next speaker. We have Dr. Sudhir Kumar here, CEO, Netflixe, IIT Kanpur. Mr. Sudhir Kumar has 22 years of experience in working in academics industry, mainly in the solar energy display and electronics industries spanning across globally. He has been working with Tata Industries and Samtel. His specializations are flexible electronics, flexible solar displays, and the contribution he is part of the business development, management operations, technology development, and commercialization. Let's hear from Dr. Sudhir Kumar about Netflixe and its services. Over to you, sir.
So thank you for the nice introduction. Good evening, good afternoon, good morning, depending on where you are. It's very late, the people may be hungry for the dinner, but let me take my slides quickly, okay? Also, thanks to the organizer for inviting me on this virtual platform. Let me start my presentation. So today I would start with the background about what is the flexible electronics. I have made my presentation a little light because a lot of the industry people are there. So let's take from the background, and then followed by the possible opportunities for printers to widen the scope. So that's what I will go through. And also I would explain about the national flexible electronics, e-activities, and possible opportunities for the printer work with the National Center of Flexible Electronics if something they find suitable. Okay. So let's start with what is the flexible and printable electronics. So these slides explain everything. We all know that we are in the world of the conventional electronics. So how it is getting manufactured, that there's a very special substrate called silicon. Size is limited. Today the industry is running a 300 millimeter dia. It might go to 450 millimeter dia. You make n number of the, you know, ICs over that. You saw them, cut them, package them, make the component, then go to the assembly, and then go to the device and a product what we use. Very impressive technology, high performance for the final product, proven technology, but big challenges. It's very expensive to set up any fab in any country like India or anywhere if you want to start. It takes a lot of money. Somewhere, if a small fab to a basically, you can say the reasonable fab around $1 to $10 billion. Not many people have that kind of money. So what next, what you can explore? There's a region that the center also came in, which is called flexible electronics. Okay, what the flexible electronics is, in a simple layman language, is it is direct fabrication on flexible substrate. The substrate could be plastic, paper, cloth, or even the steel foil. The advantage of that one, that you have the high throughput, and it potentially will be very low cost, but the performance and the stability can be poor compared to the regular electronics, because that's a proven basically from the years and years. Okay, so you have to find some opportunities with the, you know, in the path when you are developing this technology. The low hanging fruit, the small application, quick application, and take it to the market. And that's a big opportunity for the India, especially for the printer and the other industries too. Second, you know, opportunity could be to start with the hybrid electronics. Means you take the advantage of the both technologies. Hybrid as a bridge between two technologies, take the best of both worlds. Conventional electronics deploy on the flexible substrate and components. So you choose the substrate, do the printing, whatever the possible with the printing, take the established chip or the component, like Kukandi was explaining, package them and make the product and sell into the market. So there's a lot of scope was basically for the printers to enter in this field or diversify the business, okay? To widen the scope for the printer, that's the theme of this topic, what I understood. And let's see what are the opportunity and how the people should start and where are those opportunities. Now, to go to the opportunities, let me explain about the center first, because the Lakshmi was saying to give the overview about the facility and the center. Okay, the National Center for Flexible Electronics is set up at IIT Kanpur in 2014 with the financial support from the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, Government of India, and IIT Kanpur. The vision of this center is to catalyze the development of domestic industry in the field of large area flexible electronics. And this vision is being executed with the center serving as a bridge between academia ecosystem and the industrial ecosystem. So I do not know whether Professor Rao is here. I'll show you some, show in the slide what he was telling. That's what exactly executed in 2014 with the vision of the people involved here in IIT Kanpur. So if I go to the next slide, this explains in one slide about the NC Fluxy. I think the Professor Rao was hinting to that slide. Okay, you see the left-hand side is the academic ecosystem, right-hand side is the industrial ecosystem. In academic ecosystem, generally, the academician, scientists, researchers, they work for the technology development up to a TRL level of 2 and 3, means basically it is a technology which you see the light into that one or to the certain stage where you can see that yet it is working, okay? And industry, especially in India or the many country, most of the industry, if I'm not wrong, Professor Chopra is there, industry would like to take something which is readily available, take it to the shop floor, manufacture it, sell it, make the money and see the ROI. What is the ROI? What is coming in the 2 years, 3 years, not more than 3 years. So that's why the industry look at it, okay? But there is a gap in between, which we call the valley of the death, which somebody has to serve that purpose. That's what the NC Fluxy does. Okay, NC Fluxy, having a dedicated infrastructure, dedicated team, converting the technology from the academic ecosystem, gathering the knowledge, generating the knowledge, converting to the proof of concept and the prototype, keeping it ready where the industry takes it and industry manufacture it and make the money out of that. That's what in the white block, where the block you see the NC Fluxy is doing. So the industry ecosystem takes up the technology from the manufacturing, from the TRL 7 and 8, and there is a huge gap, which is basically filled by the NC Fluxy, okay? The center exactly serves the purpose, having a dedicated infrastructure, dedicated team, working only on development of various technologies to take them up to a level where industry can manufacture easily with the full knowledge and experience. So that's what is happened. And then, you know, training and education comes along with that. And if Lakshmi, you can, you know, pass the message to Professor Rao that IIT Kanpur already introduced a course, graduate course, engineering course on the flexible electronics, which is running now successfully. The facility what the center has, is a state of the art facility, approximately 5,000 square meter area. Clean room approximately 750 meter square, but it is a very unique facility where the lab to piloting can be done under one roof. Means you have equipped for the laboratory scale, pilot scale, the prototyping scale, and the piloting, where you really can check the cost of the production of any component or the technology developed, which is going to be the manufacturing. If you see further the facility, this slide explains that you have a lab scale equipment, prototyping scale equipment, and industry scale, means we also have under the same roof a pilot production line or equivalent to production line uniquely designed, which takes various technology in one platform. So you have a very versatile line where that all the technology named by Professor Chopra can be printed or can be tested or can be, the component can be manufactured using the same line. The width of this line or the roll is limited to 30 centimeter. Length could be any, the 500 meter or 1 kilometer or something, whatever you want to test or how many components you want to make it. So that's the facility which exists at the center. This is just a view graph which gives you the architecture of the line and the actual photograph which the line is running in the clean room for the purpose, because we use for the multiple component for the, you know, basically low level to a very high level, very, very complex components using the same line. Now the focus area of the center, it is to conduct the research and development in large area flexible electronics that serves as a foundation for development of domestic industry in this field. That's the mandate of the center. If you see the upper blocks, these are the core component or core technology where the center is working to. This is TFT, thin film transistor, OLED, organic light emitting diodes, OPV, sensors, very strong group for the inks, which the Kulkarni was saying that you need to have that basically inks if you want to do the printing. And the printed battery. Center has not done much in the printed battery, but the activity, there's a lot of things are going on. Combining them together as a technology integration, then you see the lower side of the slide, the integration that memory and the logic circuits, healthcare devices, I'll give you some examples, solar modules, displays, anti-counterfeiting technologies, and smart packaging. It's very difficult to take you through to all, but I will give you some examples. Let's say some examples. First example, very successful. The center has developed a technology for anti-counterfeiting tax. Okay, this is say that when it is world first copy proof levels, which is already in the market. Whenever you are passing through the Delhi airport or something, you will see this tax. It is already commercialized through incubation, which the center supports for the technology to incubate a company and commercialize the technology. It is already. Is the technology is already taken by Delhi state for the excise the stickers, and it is already in the printed with the government printing press, and you will see in many airports or many products this sticker. The same another thing is very simple one. The center what they have they have developed, the center has developed a ink which is the conductive ink. Filled in the pan, we call a conducting pan, and you see the n number of application. Is you see very right hand side, very simple. You write a line, put a just paper switch, and put a LED, and then it is glowing because you are writing like a wire, basically printing like a wire. So the educational kit is created having a booklet, connector, and conducting pan or resistive pan, where the student can make a circuit. For example, like we used to be in the science. 8 to 10th standard, make parallel or series resistance, and number of applications you can do. You can think about that. It is going to be also launched in this month in the market in certain schools or certain training places. Another good example is like we are talking the printed heaters. Okay, so the printed heaters also developed by the center. Now it is. Technology is getting transferred to a manufacturing company, especially for the jackets application, because the extensive field trial has been done here with the security people, which were very successful. But you can use in many I would say the apparels, maybe the physiotherapy or that basically shoes or somewhere wherever you need basically some heat to keep that place warm or something like that. So this is also developed. Another very good example is very simple, the smart level for IV water. You see the what happened in the hospitals, okay? The every patient is having one attendant to watch whether bottle is empty or not, okay? And even that basically doctor or nurse, sometimes they do not know whether the bottle is empty or not. So many casualties happen in the operation theaters because of those many reasons. So a very small, very simple level is designed, which has a self-calibration. It's printed with the resistive ink. Very simple on the paper. You can just paste on the bottle, take the output from there. It's a small electronic device is written. You can connect by Wi-Fi or internet anywhere to the doctor or attendant, which gives you the level of the fluid when or level of the bottle basically or alarms basically when it is getting empty. So this is one of the example. Or in the lower side of the slide, you can see another example that it is a very low cost. Somebody came here that we need a electronic signature so that nobody can duplicate a sticker. This is also one of the excise sticker from the South State. So if you see the very small electronic signature is there, which you cannot be copied, and you can check it anytime with the external device whether this sticker is original or not. Another example is the Rajesh was explaining the seven segment display. IIT being a very old facility, approximately 15-20 years. Developed so many displays. This is one of the displays for the instrument cluster because the EV vehicle is coming very fast in this market. It is developed and it is also going to be basically in one of the vehicle in coming months. This is on glass, but the center is working for with the printing the plastic substrate flexible displays. So I will see that whether I have some prototypes for that. These all are prototypes which are working and getting tested at the industry level. This is another example, developing a car conducting paste, filling in the tube, and then you make whatever you want. This is one of the piano, basically. It is made that you connect a basically proven circuitry, and then you can play like a piano. Many applications, do it yourself for the kids. So this is another example. You can do that one. Flexible sensor, not only the pressure sensor, variety of sensor which is used, especially for packaging. You can print it with the printing technology, and there's a huge scope. The printer can have a look to print those kind of sensors or smart packaging. The lot of applications in the packaging, you can have a look, basically monitoring the temperature, interacting packaging, like Rajesh was showing, that glowing some logo or branding, even for RFID in a smart packaging, track and trace, or for inventory, you can do that one. Or the one company, basically, who is a very big company, came to us that there's a, pills, like a cancer disease or something, where the patient has to take for longer time. How to remember that one? You can just print a very small circuit over the packet of the pills, and then it is very easily that you will get alarm. Yes, basically the patient has taken the pills or something. So there's a lot many examples which in especially in packaging, and other example what I have given, the printer can use, and have a look into that one. As a summary of the center, as a core technology platform, you see the vertical that center has the TFT, OLED, OPB sensor, ink, and battery. And when as an integration, we are working in memory and circuit, flexible modules, anti-counterfeiting technology, healthcare devices, flexible displays, smart packaging. To support the whole structure, you need a common platform of, let's say, large area printing and coating, where the center has from R&D to the production scale, substrate and encapsulation. You have to have the common platform substrates and patterning technology wherever is required. So that these are the overall, I would say, the matrix of the center, which gives you the overview of the center, what is happening in the center today. As the industry connects, as of now, basically 20 industry members are already there with the center. I think the 105 are already engaged in smaller or bigger projects they are discussing. Some incubations happens. There's a very dedicated team of the 100 people there. Main focus in the sectors are anti-counterfeiting, packaging, strategic, healthcare, food safety, materials, automotive, and track and trace. That's what is going, and footprint is increasing, as you see in the slides here. Okay. Then I would say in the end, let's find a relevant application and work together. You all are most welcome whenever you find the time to visit and have a look. If something is useful, we will be happy to support. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. I think each of the speakers have gradually given us an amazing presentation. To think that printer electronics can do so much, and printers have the opportunity to enter into this, is really very amazing. And definitely, as our director sir had mentioned, the ecosystem should have been well established. Only then this kind of innovative products can come out. We need to definitely have a collaboration. Sudhir sir, director sir, is still connected.
Oh, okay. Now, I think you were saying that I was thinking to keep you in your mind, maybe when you were interacting at that time, it was under discussion, but there is a graduate course on the flexible, fundamental of flexible electronics is already introduced for the bachelor students in IIT Kanpur. And students are really opting that course very well. So it is going, and some other university also should do that. Right? Second thing you were saying that IIT Kanpur, yes, it is a national center, and definitely that anybody need any support or collaboration, we help them. Okay, it is a very established model, which is working. Professor Chopra also visited us, I think that 2-3-4 months back, he has seen the facility. So what center looks in a university or in a institute is a small center, but itself is an institute, is a separate building of 6 floor, having 2 blocks. It's a very large setup, actually, having everything under one roof. And I have worked globally. I have spent most of the time outside, but I tell you that I have seen such kind of center, but it's very rare you will see where lab to the production you will get at one place. So So that's the advantage of this center. So people has really put a lot of effort to bring this center at this stage. So what you were saying, that is very well needed, and that's what is executed in IIT Kanpur. So you all are most welcome anytime, basically, if you need any support.
Thank you, sir. Now let's have questions. Kanchana madam has a question. Kanchana?
I'm Kanchana, assistant professor working in Department of Computing Technology, Anna University, Chennai. Thank you, ma'am, for arranging so knowledgeable sessions for the past 3 weeks. And thank you to AIFMP also. I have three questions, sir. The first one is to Sudhir, sir. The first one, first question is, sir, do you have any NPTEL course for our students to take in this line? And shall I tell all the three questions, ma'am?
Well, I can answer this one. You know that website, you go there. I think, I don't know whether in the flexible economies it already introduced, but there was a discussion, there should be. So it will not be direct printing, but I tell you that for your, we used to take the students earlier for the summer courses. But our problem was that the application, we were handling such a huge application across the country. It was really very, very difficult. So last year onwards, what we have decided that course only for industry, because people like Professor K.L. Chopra, they want that industry should come in. So a lot of industries are coming, but definitely I'll find out there are some courses in detail. Absolutely.
Thank you, sir. So the second question is, we have some small facilities in our department, like we have a microfab inkjet printer, we have a combination dryer and some printing equipment. So, but the problem is in sourcing the inks at affordable price for the students, because we don't have that much money for buying the conductive inks. Can you suggest any resource for this?
See, now I also belong to an academic setup. Okay, so you know the answer. So the commercial company generally, I don't know why, that most of the time they exploit, basically, if you add a small quantity, they will charge you whatever they want to charge. So what I can help you and suggest you is something. If you are looking for, let's say, conductive ink or something, let us know, because we have developed the conductive ink. Whatever we can give it to any outside company, we'll give it to you also. And free of cost.
Thank you so much, sir.
Problem is any ink which is underdeveloped, because I tell you, the piece which I have not mentioned, the center has taken lot many, advanced stage active component assignment from the defense, okay, ISRO or something. So there are certain components, certain inks basically are getting used on those security things that we would be not, it will not be possible to share with you. But conducting, yes, probably that I'll ask my team, they will support you.
Thank you so much, sir. And the third, last question is, now people are talking about the environmental issues and things. Now with the advent of IoTs and lots of printable electronics, what would be the solution or how we should progress in our research?
The sky is the limit, I can tell you. You think about that, apply the IoT, printable is the best, you can make it a solution and go for market. If you have any idea, Kanchana, I can also tell you that time to time what we do the flexi hackathon. Okay.
Okay, sir.
We award the prize, we give the money as well. For that,
okay.
Any idea, anything you need, please take my email address from Lakshmiji and write to us. We'll support.
Thank you so much. That's all, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Kanchana ma'am, for asking for things. We will also join into that group. Any other questions?
Dr. Sudhir, I just wanted to know whether you can provide sabbaticals.
Difficult to answer, I don't, let me check that one. That's a difficult piece.
And I just wanted to request Jay sir and Sudhir sir and Sadhana sir, whether they can provide small training, weekly or some training to our entrepreneurs, the printer who want to shift to the printed electronic. If some training, maybe these days they can organize on Zoom also, so that they can understand how they can convert to the printed electronic.
So Professor Chopra, that in NC Flexi and especially in IIT Kanpur, this is the pandemic year, so we could not do that one. But I tell you that every year in July, first week, okay, we invite the industry, especially the industries, okay? That is the short course as well as some trainings, live trainings. They can go in the lab, they can ask the question. Even then, they can basically do the small, if they want to basically see how the process are running. We keep on running the equipment and even the, our large machine, the roll-to-roll machine. So certainly, that is the one established, platform. Beyond that, it is just on a request, basically, they can visit and we will see that in a mode. We have also the mode of working with the industry, which you know that one. But July, for 7 days, minimum 5 days, that is open. They can apply and we try to accommodate almost all the applicants, okay? Provide them the accommodation inside the campus. Sometimes more people come so that we request them to stay outside, but we try to that one, provide the food, everything, and then they can enjoy the campus. Absolutely. So July is the month. Most likely next year it could definitely happen. We hope so. This year it could not happen because of the pandemic. Yeah. So we do that. We do that. Rajesh Kulkarni also visited, I think, the center basically. I don't know whether it's
Rajesh, yes, sir. Yeah, Rajesh sir, can you provide the training? Some training, maybe you can provide a virtual platform. The basic, how do you do the job?
Yeah. Sure, we can do that. We'll be in touch with Lakshmi Priya madam. We can do that, but we need to see like who are the students, because they should be really interested in doing something, and they should have some basic knowledge of printing also. Yeah. Because if we start answering basic questions, then it becomes difficult. So they should be at some level of graduating to printed electronics.
No, sir. Yes, sir. I'm talking of the printers who are basically now printers who are doing the commercial printing or packaging. So they are already printers. They know the printing very much, I think so.
Yeah.
For them, it's short training for them. We will organize the people at federation level, the person who are interested, maybe 5, 6, 7.
Yeah.
If it is possible.
Yes. Of course, we can support. No problem.
Thanks, sir. Thank you.
So, I give you one. Yes, it is coming in my mind. We will see that how we can implement it. Maybe that when the time permits for the travel, you can make the 2-3 batches of 12-13 people, 12-15 people max, because otherwise it becomes difficult for many, for many things to handle. Send them to the campus for 2 days here. Okay. And let them go there, and then we will basically, I will arrange few people who can have the classroom as well as the taking them to the center, showing them everything, whatever they are, some kind of training. We can do that. Okay. Basically, it will be good basic for them also to see and learn. Something can be done. That can be also.
Thank you, sir.
We have a question from Shanos. So would you like to ask a question?
Yes, ma'am. My name is Shanos. The session was, first of all, I want to congratulate all the presentation, and it was a very nice session. I would like to ask, I'm a printing technology graduate, and if I wanted to enter into the field of printed electronics as a technologist, so what are the possibilities have in India right now? Is there any courses which we can take further as a master's or something else, or PG diploma, anything else right now?
I don't think there's any training for except IIT Kanpur. They are not virtually doing the printing. They are doing only in the electronics. But now there's a problem due to COVID, but at the level of All India Federation, we are sending batches to BIGC, Beijing Institute of Graphic Communication, where the printing along with the printed electronic, they can learn. So in India, the only source is IIT Kanpur. But I think their admission will be very difficult. IIT,
yes. you have to go to the normal process.
Yeah, that's
the normal process. And time to time, we have a specific programs in the NC Flexi, which we publish at the website. Okay, you please have a look, and you have to go to the process. IT process basically is a process.
Yeah, that's a process.
On behalf of everybody, I will ask the common question. Sudhirji, if the printers and the printing institutes combine together and identify a batch of participants, will you be able to give us a virtual orientation like how Kamalji was telling? Because we do not know when the pandemic will come to end. There are chances that printers can enter into printed electronics right now. So probably they can give the job to you or give the job to Rajesh ji. But then they should have a basic idea of what kind of print jobs they can take in. So for that, they need a foundation. They need to know a little bit of printed electronics. If you can give them a 1 or 2 day orientation, a virtual walk through your center or something like that, maybe you and Rajesh ji together, then they will have a fair idea of how confidence to enter into this. Should that be possible?
Yeah, so let me tell you, and then I will basically take this question back to you. Virtual, I believe, should not be any problem because I can ask some of the team later. They can, because it's good for the students or for the country. So absolutely no problem. But the having the you can say the physical tour in the center for the university and students, there is a little restrictions, because Professor Chopra will tell you the center, even to get the entry in the center for a professor of the IIT is also not free. Okay, so there is a dedicated mentors here, and other than that, any professor, any faculty, anybody, they're most welcome, but there is a procedure to that. Okay, because there is a certain confidentiality. If the Professor Chopra is coming, I want to do basically this development with you and take the technology in the manufacturing, so we have to respect his confidentiality. That's what they're having in the center. So in one piece of the center is where the only industry can go. Okay, they have a separate place to sit. We maintain the full confidentiality of the industry and respect that their NDAs and agreement, what we do that one. So that's a limitation. But virtual, I think, should be workable for basically is a short, you can say, orientation or something. We would definitely think, and we can do something for that, for sure. Not issue. Virtual should not be a problem.
Thank you.
So thank you, sir. Thank you for your time. So
thanks. Thanks a lot. Thank you.
We'll be keeping in touch.
No, yes, sure.
Yeah, madam, there is a question on chat. There's I heard that the electronic can be printed in offset. Is there any facility in India?
Vishwaji is asked.
Dr. Daksham is there, Dr. Nazaro. Sir, can you elaborate?
Yeah. No, the problem is still not solved, because the ink is a problem there.
Yes.
And that has to be taken care of.
Sir, I have something to say here.
Yes, sir. Rajesh, sir.
Inkjet is possible, and if you know a company called Fuji Diamatics in US, I have visited their facility in 2008. And before even that, they were manufacturing inkjet printers to print printed electronics. So there are several companies who have come up with inkjet printers, and they have their own nano inks, and you can print it through inkjet printers. There is no doubt about that.
Yeah.
And the same ink can be used for offset by some modifications. Only thing is the cost of the nano ink is very, very, very high.
Kamalji, I have one thing to say.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now,
yes, sir.
With the Modi's push on Atmanirbhar Bharat, and with the recent Nirmala Sitharaman's budget, you see there was an encouragement for local manufacturing of components like ICs and so on. These printed electronics will be a very important topic of the future.
Yeah, right.
Now, as the printing industry, and we also have people from IIT, I think today's session was very, very interesting for everyone. Can we not have a small group or a association to promote this even vigorously on a fast track mode?
Sir, actually we are planning that. That's why I asked Dr. Sudhir about it. And Ashok sir, we need you also. Hyderabad, we can also contribute in it. We will form a group of the interested painters who wish to convert to printed electronic. And then we will organize a small training. And that was in my mind. That's why I asked this question to Sudhir.
Correct. And digital entry into offset is of course well known, but digital entry into flexo is also very well known.
Yes.
Now with inkjet and nanotechnologies which we spoke about, along with the flexo technology, I think this should be an easy entry for us. And my other question was, you have visited China and all that. You know, China is the hub for all electronics.
Yes,
everything is getting manufactured in China. And surely there must be something connected with the printed electronics in China, which we are not so well aware of, which I think if we can call some speakers from there, it will add value to this. This is just a suggestion.
Ashok sir, I told already that in Beijing Institute of Graphic Communication, there's a training for printed electronics. And at the level of AIFMP, we are sending batches there. But nowadays, due to strange relations, it was not possible. We invited their person for speaking, but the timing was not suitable to them because it is now 6:30 here. At that, there will be 9 at their place. Maybe some other time we can invite the person, the professor is there, we can invite the professor who are providing training in printed electronics.
Correct. But, sir, this is the best opportunity for us to take outside talent also into these conferences. Because you see, we are not traveling. We are all sitting at home and learning a lot. And you're doing a fantastic job by talking to the Indian speakers. That is, of course, very good. But also try to invite, using your influence, all the foreign guest speakers also. Maybe one more session like this or something. It will be fantastic learning for everyone. Just a request. I hope you can think of it.
Thanks for the suggestion, sir. We will definitely do it. And in one of our seminar, you was there. Two speakers. One was from UK. One was from Norway for the color section. You was there on that.
Correct.
Definitely, sir. We will invite. I tried for Chinese speaker on this, but due to time constraint and due to these habits, these days the relations, it was not possible. But we will do it. And then thank you for your suggestion. We will try to invite them. Thanks, sir. Thank you.
Now, yes, for the vote of thanks, may I have the honor of calling upon the printer who is one among the Power 100 Print Week's 2021's Power 100%, Mr. G. N. Vishwakumar, Honorary General Secretary, AIFMP, and MD of Rajam Digital Offset Chennai. We should all know that he is a BA from defense graduate. He's a BA defense. So let us hear from him. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, madam. Good evening. We have reached the end of the session. I take this opportunity to put my gratitude into words. On behalf of the office bearers of and members of AIFMP, I'd like to express my heartfelt thanks to all the participants of the webinar for their presence and contribution. This is the seventh webinar in the series, started by our president, Kamal Chopra. Thank you, Kamal Ji, for your efforts. I extend my gratitude to our Honorable Chief Guest, Professor Dr. Raja Ram, Director, School of Engineering, Avinashalinga Institute for Women. I have to take out time from his busy schedule to grace the event. Thank you for the detailed presentation on printed electronics, its evolution, the modes of printing, the substrates, inks, printing process, challenges, ecosystem and the need for developing skilled faculties. Thank you, sir, for the inspiring and encouraging words. Thanks to Mr. Swanandan Uthukwa, Sultan Gravis and his daughter, Aishwarya, for their presentation. I extended my gratitude to Mr. Rajesh Kulkarni, Director of Keytronics Pune, for his presentation on inbound electronics. The components of inbound electronics like stretchable links, conductive glue, the basic equipment and its various applications, and for demonstrating various products to the audience. Thank you, sir. My heartfelt thanks to Mr. Sudhir Kumar, CEO of National Center for Flexible Electronics, IIT Kanpur, for his inputs on conventional electronics to flexible electronics, hybrid technology, and for the intro of National Center for Flexible Electronics and sharing light on the academic and industrial ecosystem, the facilities of the center, and anti-counterfeiting products, smart labels, and other items, sir. Thank you, sir. And I must thank Professor Dr. Lakshmi Priya, HOD Department of Printing Technology, Avinashalinga University, for moderating this webinar. Thank you all once again. Thank you all and good night.
Thank you very much. Thank you all for your time.